all in the one drawing file, and now I would have set up a layout with some annotation and particularly dimensions and text. And so for that, I'll need to establish a scale as well. So you can see down here that I'm on the model tab, and I'm going to switch over to a new layout. I'm going to make a new layout from scratch, even though I already have one there that's, you can probably tell if I click onto it, already set up. But again, I'm going to start from scratch to go through all the steps. So we'll click on the plus there to make a new layout called layout 2. You may already have that, so if you do, you can always just select it and it should look just like mine with a default page size, and you'll see something in the viewport. Don't matter what it is, it'll just have something that you've drawn already. You're going to change that. So before I change anything on the page, though, I need to set that page up. And so to do that, I'm going to right-click on the new layout, on layout 2, and then go to the page setup manager. And so then in this dialog box, I'll click modify. And I'm going to change to the DWG to PDF printer. Then I'll choose a page size, so we want A3. I'm just going to choose ISO A3, not ISO full bleed, so I'll just need to find that. There we are, so ISO A3, 420 by 297. I'm going to check that what to plot is set to layout. Scale should be 1:1, but you'll also need to check that your units are on millimetres, so if your units were inches, you'll need to change them to millimetres and then check again that it stays on 1:1, or choose that again. And then the plot style table should be monochrome. Okay, so that's everything I need for the page. I'm going to click OK and then close, and now we can see the new page size. And so I'll select the viewport now, and going to my layers, you can see I've already made a layer called viewport, which I'm just going to choose there and change the viewport onto that layer. If you don't have that layer, you'll need to make it. So if I go to layer properties there, then you can see the viewport layer I've made just there. You can obviously just use the new layer button to make that. And then you can set any color you like. Main option there is that it's set to be non-printing, so you need to choose that printer icon there and make sure it's got the do not print. So next I'm going to insert my title block. So in the block panel there, I'll go to insert and then more options and then browse. And then I'm going to go and find the title block from the folder on the P drive, or student resources. And then EDUDC interior design. And then the class folder, which is, or the subject folder, which is Digital Communication Studio. And then AutoCAD resources. So there, if you scroll down, you'll find title block. So I'm just going to click open. And then I'm going to just make sure I've only got specifying screen ticked for insertion point, but not for scale or rotation. So I'm just going to leave them both turned off. And I'm going to click OK. And if you have this message, just click redefine block. And then to place it, you might need to zoom out a little bit so that you can click onto the bottom left corner of the page. So that's the white area there. Not the dashed line, you have to go to the very corner of the page. And then click to place and enter your details. So I'll put mine. You can use tab to switch to the next field. And so call this assessment 2. The sheet title will be Boardroom will be the first one, I suppose. 1-inch title block. But the scale bar, notice, is the color of my current layer. So that shows you that the block does have a layer. The title block is a block. And some of the things on that in that block will take on the layer's properties. And so I already have made a layer called ANO title. And if you want to know the properties, I've just made that with the default line weight. Again, any color you like, but I tend to make annotation white. And leave the line top continuous, of course. So now I can select that title block by clicking anywhere on those lines and then change the layer to ANO title. And then I'm just going to zoom out and select my title, also my viewport. And then using the grips on the corner, I'm going to click and then just make that a little bit bigger so you can see how to adjust the size of your viewport. And so now I want to change what I can see inside it. And I'll show you a few different ways of doing that. So firstly, you can click on the button that says paper down on the status bar. And you'll see it'll move when you choose it because some of the options change. It moves to the end and it changes to model. That shows you that you're in model space. And it's similar to drawing on the model tab. You can draw in this mode. And when you zoom or pan, holding the wheel down to pan, of course, it again zooms or pans just inside the viewport. So the normal process is to use those view controls, zoom and pan basically, to center what you want to see inside that viewport, and then choose the scale. And remember, scale is just another word for zoom. So by choosing 1 to 50 here, it's essentially going to zoom a little bit more accurately so that it's exactly 1 to 50. And so if I zoom again now using the wheel, of course that's going to change the scale again. I'll go back to 1 to 50. You can pan holding the wheel down and that'll move the objects in the view, but really it's not moving them, it's just changing the view. So that's another way of adjusting what you can see inside the viewport. And that won't change the scale when you pan. So you can pan as much as you like, but try not to zoom once you've set the scale. And then finally, I'm going to lock that scale now. So once you can see what you want, then you'll see next to the scale button, two buttons to the left, is a little lock symbol. If you click there, that prevents the scale from changing. So if I zoom now, you'll see the whole page zooms, even though I'm in model space. So that's a good option. If I click on the model button now, that takes me back to paper space, and I can select the title block again or the viewport. I'm going to just right click there and choose deselect all, and I'll show you another method, and that is to double click. If you double click, that again takes you into model space, activates the viewport, and if you want to go back to paper space using a similar method, you can double click on the page and that takes you back to paper. And finally, one last method, MS is the shortcut for model space, and then PS, enter, is the shortcut for paper space. And so you'll find a lot of people actually draw